nanoHUB-U, online instruction.
Hey everyone, in the last lecture we just talked about how CAMFR can solve the S-matrix problem in the presence of eigenmode solutions in each layer using Lorentz reciprocity. Now we're going to talk about how to use this like for real calculations. And so in this particular example, we're using CAMFR to calculate the band structure of a 2D photonic crystal based on the concept we said earlier that you can perform a singular value decomposition of repeated periodic structure and then easily invert the matrix in order to extract the eigenmodes of the system. Then we can actually get, as you can see here, if we have K in this direction, KZ, and then we span the Brillouin zone from the gamma point where K equals zero to X, which is pi over A, then you can see that we have like an increase as a function of K for the first band, and then we have a band gap, which is here, right? And then we have the second mode, another band gap. So this is actually very consistent with some of the earlier calculations we did in unit one for band structures, but arrived at in a significantly different way. And we don't necessarily have to limit ourselves to such a simple structure. We can also potentially have a photonic crystal 2D structure, which has some sort of defect or lack of rods in one region. And then that can form a defect waveguide. And so you can see here that not only do you have something similar to what we showed before, which was basically a band gap, but then you have like this even mode that's a defect mode that fills in that space. And of course, it depends a bit on how big this gap is and what the refractive index is and so on. But in this particular case, you see this even mode actually spans a large part of the band gap. And then where you are located in the band gap will determine how tight the spatial confinement is within this defect region. Basically, the closer you are to the middle of the band gap, then the more rapid spatial decay you have as you leave that defect region. And you can see here kind of what fields are associated with this solution. And so it's actually decaying pretty rapidly. So you actually only need about three or four periods of the photonic crystal in order to accurately capture that mode. And of course, you can repeat it like periodically in this direction. So that's not a problem. And so in order to actually do some calculations in CAMFR, first of all, it's available on SourceForge. So you can download it from camfr.sourceforge.net. And then you can actually start adding that to your Python installation. If you don't have Python, that's also freely available. You can install that either just as a direct binary download, or you can build it from source code, depending on your preference. And then once you have Python set up, and then you install CAMFR as a module into Python, and the instructions are, of course, contained within the package, then you can start writing code and running it within Python with CAMFR module. Okay, so basically this first line just tells you to invoke Python from the shell. Okay, so there's the shell command. Second one is actually the first Python command, and it says to import all of the functions of the CAMFR library. And then you start like actually setting up your simulation. In this particular case, we're trying to set a wavelength for the system. And so you can think of when we set lambda to one, think of it as 1 micron, for example. And then set n is basically the number of eigenmodes that are allowed in the system. Set the polarization, that should be obvious. Setting the materials, it's also pretty obvious. The number we're providing is just the real index. But then this is slightly less obvious when we create a slab. So in this case, what we're doing is we're saying based on the materials we chose, then we want to create like layers that have different thicknesses. And so air 2 basically says air region of thickness 2 microns. And so then that's located here. And then we have a gallium arsenide thickness of 0.5 micron. So this ultra thin gallium arsenide, perhaps made through epitaxial liftoff, plus some more air. and then you basically run the calculation for like the transmission reflection of this 1D waveguide. And so not surprisingly, of course, like since gallium arsenide has such a high refractive index, it readily guides modes within the gallium arsenide. And in this case, we assumed it has no loss. So this is a true guided mode, which has like basically this Gaussian looking distribution of field. And then it has effective index profile that's basically pure real, which is kind of one of the four types of eigenmodes that we talked about earlier for the guided mode. In the next lecture, we'll go through like more applications for CAMFR.